Hey, I'm Jesse Hunt with Unofficial. We're a web design and digital marketing agency located in downtown Memphis. Since 2002, I've been helping Mid-South businesses just like yours improve their websites and find more customers on the internet. Today, I'm going to perform a video website audit on your website that'll show you some areas for improvement that might be hurting your business. The entire audit will take 15 to 20 minutes and should leave you substantially more informed about what's working and what's not working so well on your website. I hope you'll find the audit informative and that you'll keep me in mind if you ever need some help working on your existing website or building a new one. Thanks a lot for watching. Let's get started.
Hey, Rick. So here we are on the homepage of your website, supplylinememphis.com. And what I want to do is take just a few minutes, scroll through your website, make a few observations about what I'm seeing here on the website. From there, we'll go over to some tools that Google provides and get a little bit of information about what Google's telling us about your site. We'll look at some Google search results, then we'll come back and look at a few tools that I've got installed here on my computer to get some insight about what's happening behind the scenes on your site. I'll try to keep it brief. Don't want to take up too much of your time or overwhelm you here, so let's dig in. When I land on your first on your website, the first thing I notice here is, honestly, I think my eye was drawn to the background first. This kind of gray honeycomb looking thing. I'm not sure exactly what that picture is. It almost felt a little distracting, I think. Next thing I noticed was your logo up here. And particularly the logo is on this white background, and then there's this empty blue space over here to the right, and maybe more specifically that the logo looks pretty bad. It's low quality. It's like the logo that was used for the website was a lower resolution file, or was rather that it was compressed too much. When you compress an image, it loses its quality and it gets this kind of faded look. I'm not sure exactly what the right word is here, but you see how it's dark in some places and it's got little splotches of color in it. That's just a matter of this logo was compressed way too much and it makes it look bad. Honestly, if I'm looking at the homepage of a website, especially when the logo's that big and bold right there in front of me, I think the logo should be perfectly crisp and sharp. That's the first thing that you want people to see and recognize whenever they land on your website. So definitely think the logo needs to be improved here. From there, as I scroll down through here, man, I don't mean any offense by any of this. I just I tell it the way I see it, and I hope that doesn't cause any offense here. But the website just looks really dated to me. I don't know when it was built. Down here in the footer, it says content copyright 2016 Supply Line Memphis. But my guess is that footer just gets updated with a new year whenever the year changes, and that this website's probably older than that. So it just feels outdated. As I scroll through here, the content, this black text on this gray background is a little hard to read. Studies have shown that dark text on a light background is best. So you've got the dark text. I think the background's just too busy and too it lacks contrast with the text. Beyond that, it's the pictures are laid out where you've got this picture over here, which originally I thought was a video. I thought, oh, that's pretty cool. And so I clicked on it and I wanted to see the video, and it's actually just a photo slideshow. So once I click on it, it rotates through these pictures, but it's not actually a video happening there. I think it would be really cool if you had a video that actually played on here. But given that this is just a photo slideshow, I'd probably get rid of these controls that make it look like it's a video. Same thing over here. I think this one does the same thing. Yeah, just another photo slideshow, but it's got this video player that makes it look like it's a more substantial feature. So I'd probably change these up and make them either make them where they're rotating photos or make them where they're actual videos, one or the other. Just overall, the homepage feels like it's a little scattered. A two-column design doesn't bother me much. In fact, if you look at my website, I've got a two-column design on my website, but it's straight down the middle. In fact, let's pull that up and look at it real quick. So as you pull my website up here, once it loads, you know, I've got a two-column layout, but it's split down the middle where you've got content on each side. When we come back over here to your website, it's not split down the middle, so it feels kind of jagged here. This content comes over, and then this comes back over here. There's no real center line, so it just feels a little messy, I guess you'd say. So let's click on services and products here. I actually haven't been to this page yet. Again, it just feels a little messy. These pictures here, I'd really like to see a nice crisp line here. Maybe these pictures should have some kind of little border around them, like a white frame or something, just to make them look crisp and clean. But at the very least, even if they do butt up to each other like this, it feels like they should really be lined up on the side here. So they're lined up perfectly on the left. See how nice and clean that looks? But then you look at them on the right, and it's just not, they just don't line up. Over here, same thing on the pictures on the right. They line up perfectly on the left, but they don't line up on the right. So they feel jagged and uneven. That's just a matter of setting your image sizes properly when setting up the website. Next here, I see you've got product page. Product page, product page two, product page three. To me, that's just confusing. I don't understand what the difference between product page one and product page three is. I don't understand why you wouldn't have all of the products on one page. If you're going to have if you're going to have it broken down into multiple pages, then I think they should be separated by categories. And so we'd have to talk and figure out what the right categories are. But, you know, maybe you've got a category for plumbing fixtures, pipes, and then valves or something like that, or, you know, water heaters or whatever. I don't know. I don't know what the right categories are. More likely to me, though, the logical way to do it would be I would create a page for products and then have a drop-down menu that when you hover over it drops down and will let you choose from the category of product that you want. So you hover over it, products, and then it drops down and maybe it says plumbing fixtures, water heaters, pipes, valves, whatever. I mean, certainly you know your categories better than I do, and we could discuss that if you want my help in fixing all this. But it just doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me right now the way that it's broken up. The other thing I notice is, so I'm here right now on the products page two, and I notice all these are links. So these are logos for the different brands that you sell. And when I hover over them, I notice that they link to the vendor's website or rather to the manufacturer's website. Now my question here is, if I were to click on these, how many of these websites have a way to do like a search to find a dealer for their products? And if I went to some of these and did a search for other dealers, if I put in Memphis, would I be able to find your competition? And so, in other words, by linking to these people, are you potentially actually leading customers away from your website and over to your competition? That's something that I always have a concern about. Anytime you link to somebody else's website, that especially if it's somebody that multiple competitors sell the same brand of product. I haven't clicked through these to find out if that's the case, but I'd be willing to bet that at least on some of them it is. The other thing, these logos, some of them have a white background, some of them have an image background, some of them have a black background. I just feel like it'd be a lot cleaner if they were consistent. So either all on white backgrounds or all on black backgrounds, lined up maybe somehow. I just feel like all these product pages could be made to look a lot cleaner and nicer. And then finally, I come over here to your contact page. On the contact page, I notice a few things. One, if you look right here, I don't know if you can see that. Oops, didn't mean to highlight it. All right, right here, there's a little icon thing. And then again here, and again here, and again here, and again here. What those are broken images. So it looks like there should be a picture there, and here, and here, and here. But for whatever reason, those pictures are broken. They're not showing up properly. Definitely need to fix that. It just looks bad having broken images on the website. Beyond that, I like a lot of the things on this page. I like that you've got your hours of operation. I like that you've got your phone number. I like that that you've got numbers for sales, your fax number, all your contact information here. You got your mailing address and a contact form. I'm curious if you get emails from this contact form. If you're not getting emails from this contact form, I'm, you know, it might be worth checking into to make sure it works. If the pictures are broken, so too might this contact form be broken. So the other thing, I notice you've got all these email addresses here for your staff. I'm curious, do you get a ton of spam? Do all these addresses get tons of spam? A lot of times whenever you put a whole bunch of email addresses on a page like this, you end up getting a whole bunch of spam because these computers come through and they scan your website and they save all these email addresses and they put you in a big database, and the next thing you know, you're getting blown up with spam email. So if that's the case, you might consider getting rid of this and just maybe modifying your contact form so there's a drop-down menu where somebody can select who it is they're wanting to send a message to, fill out the form, and then submit a message to you directly through the form without actually having your email address on the website. So that's a possibility. The only other thing I'd say on your website before I move on here, I feel like maybe there should be more text content on the website. Google really likes text content. The more text you have, the better off you do in the search engines. Google doesn't understand pretty pictures and slideshows and stuff like that. Google understands text. So give them lots of text and they'll reward you for that in terms of sending you visitors and sending quality, you know, people that are searching for what you do, which ultimately the more visitors you get, then, you know, the more prospects you get through the website, and more leads equal more sales, more return on investment. So definitely want to try to give Google what it's looking for. Speaking of Google, I'm going to click over to this tab that I've got open here. Now, this is a tool that Google provides to website developers. It's called the Mobile Friendly Test. Google wants to see that websites are mobile friendly because so many people are using mobile devices these days. So I ran this test a few minutes ago, and it came back. It said failed to fetch the requested URL. I'm going to run it again here and see. It seems to be having problems scanning your website. I'm going to change it up just a little bit and see if I can get it to run. And meanwhile, I'm going to open one more tool. It seems to be having a problem. So we're going to search Bing Mobile Friendly Test. They have a similar tool. And let's try it there. Now, the fact that... Oops, that's not what I wanted. The fact that Google is unable to scan your website as a mobile device on their Mobile Friendly Test could be an indication of a problem. You may have a problem with Google being able to view your website the way that a mobile device would. If that's the case, you definitely want to fix that. Google announced back in April of 2015 that they were going to show preference to websites that were mobile friendly and provide better search results for those websites, particularly for people using mobile devices. And so you want to make sure that your website's mobile friendly. Now here, Bing appears that it was able to successfully scan your website, and they say that your website is mobile friendly. They say your viewport's configured correctly, the page content fits the device width, text on the page is readable, links and tap targets are sufficiently large and touch friendly. It says that some resources on the page are blocked by the robots.txt configuration. My guess is this right here is why Google can't scan the site to make sure that it's mobile friendly. So definitely want to fix that if that's what's causing Google to not be able to scan your website, because it looks like you've got a mobile friendly website, but due to this, Google may not even be able to tell that it's mobile friendly. Definitely want to fix that. You know, honestly, as I'm looking here at the mobile version of your website, I think it looks nicer than the public version of your site. So I think that's good, at least, in my opinion. Now let's cover some other good news. I did some Google searches. I tried to put myself in the shoes of a potential visitor to your website or a potential customer and said, if I were looking for what these guys do, what might I type into Google in order to find you, assuming that I didn't already know who you were. And so the first thing I typed in was Memphis Plumbing Supply. Now, the first thing that comes up on this page is this map result here. Excuse me. So this map result shows a map, and then it shows three listings. Sometimes this is referred to as the three-pack. These listings are determined heavily based on location, based on having your address, your name, address, and phone number match up on your website as well as on your Google listing, and then also across the internet, and then having good reviews helps to rank better here. So as you can see, you're showing up in the number three spot here. Definitely good that you're showing up in this result. It would be better, obviously, if you were in the number one spot. So might be worth looking into, you know, what kind of optimization can be done to move you from number three to number one, but at least you're in this listing. As we scroll down below that, from here down, we call these organic listings or free listings. Basically, you show up in these listings by having a website that's optimized well, that has the right keywords in the right places, the right number of times, by having other websites link back to your website, by having a website or domain name that's been around for a while. So the older your domain name gets, the more trustworthy you seem to Google and the more traffic they'll send you. Now, you're showing up in the number two spot here on the organic results. Again, would be better if you were number one, but number two is certainly not bad. Overall, your search engine rankings are really pretty good. My guess is there probably isn't a ton of competition in your market here in the Memphis area, and so that gives you an advantage where even if your website's not terribly search engine optimized, you still have a good chance of showing up in the search results because there's just not that much competition. So next, I searched Memphis Pipe Supply. Here you're showing up number one in the map results and number one in the organic results, so that's great. I searched pipe supplies in Memphis. Here you're showing up number two and number one. So your search engine rankings really aren't too bad. Now, the bad news is that can change at any time. All it takes is for Google to change their way that they index websites, and it can totally change their rankings. Likewise, it could take one competitor that decides to get really aggressive and decides to optimize a bunch of other websites for the same keywords, and suddenly you're getting pushed out of the search results. So your results are good right now, but you might want to take some steps to improve the website just to make sure that you're secure in those rankings and that you're not at risk of being pushed out of the results by a particularly aggressive competitor or by something that that Google decides to change. Now, back on your website here, I've got a little tool installed in my browser that I'm going to open up. This is called the Google Tag Assistant, and basically what it does, it scans your website and searches for any Google tags that might be installed in the code of your website. As you can see, result of tag analysis, zero in total. So there are no Google tags installed on your website. Now, specifically, I was hoping to find a tag called Google Analytics. Google Analytics allows you to track how many visitors are coming to your website, what they're doing while they're there, so which pages do they look at, and which pages do they click on first, and what do they do, how do they end up leaving the website? Did they go to your Contact Us page and fill out a form, or did they land on your homepage, stay for just a few seconds, and then immediately bounce and go somewhere else? Google Analytics gives you really good data to be able to track how well your website's performing as a marketing tool and whether or not you're getting a good return on investment. Since you don't have Google Analytics installed, I would highly recommend installing it. It's free software. You probably need somebody with a little bit of HTML experience in order to get it installed for you, but it'll give you really good data to be able to know whether or not your website's performing well for you and whether it's generating the business that it needs to be. Finally, I've got one other tool installed here on my browser that we're going to look at, and then I'll wrap this thing up for you. The last thing we've got here is called SEO Quake, and this is their page SEO audit, page search engine optimization audit. Basically, it scans through the code on your website, breaks down different factors that affect how well a website is optimized for the search engines, and then displays it in a nice pretty format here so I can go through and real quickly hit the highlights without having to dig through a bunch of code in order to show you what I'm talking about. So the first thing I want to look at is title tag. Now, if we come back over here to your site real quick, if we look right up here at the top of the browser, you'll notice this where it says homepage right here in this tab. That's where your browser displays your title tag. Likewise, if we come over here to Google, if we look right here above your listing where it says Supply Line of Memphis here, this is where Google usually displays a title tag. Now, because your title tag says homepage, Google doesn't want to show their visitors text that says homepage, so Google just changes that and they put the name of your business there instead. That's kind of a missed opportunity because, in my opinion, that title tag is the most important place to put keywords if you want to rank well for them in the search engines. So we could potentially do some research, find some keywords that you're not currently ranking well for, add those into the title tags and help you show up in the search engines for additional keywords. Not to mention, if we're looking here at all these tabs open across the top of the browser, if we had, you know, four or five more tabs, and the title tags describe all these really well, and then yours says homepage. So that's not very descriptive. If somebody has multiple tabs open and they're trying to get back to your website, that doesn't help them get back to where they're trying to go very well. Next thing here, meta description. So if we go back to the search engine result, we talked about this being the title tag. Obviously, this is your website address here. And then below it, there's some text that describes the content on your website, or describes what somebody might find whenever they come to your website. When it's available on the website, this is usually the meta description tag. This is where Google displays the meta description tag. Like your title tag, your meta description tag just says homepage. That's not a very good meta description. So meta description doesn't really help you to rank higher in the search engines, but it does give you the ability to describe why somebody should click your website instead of the competition. So by having really compelling meta description tags, it gives you the ability to convince somebody to click on you instead of, say, Falk Supply down here. So the difference between a great meta tag and a lousy meta tag could be the difference between you getting the customer and your competitor getting the customer. Definitely recommend improving your meta tags on all the pages on your website. Next thing here, H tags. It looks like you've got some H tags installed on your website. They've got some of your keywords. This tool suggests adding more. I think in the grand scheme of the things that we've noticed on your site so far, this is probably a fairly small one. Text to HTML ratio. They said you've got 25.22% text on the website, which is not bad, but they suggest adding more text to your website. I tend to agree. More. I mentioned that earlier. More text is always better. So the more text you can give Google, the better you'll rank. This one's interesting. I actually didn't notice this yet, but it says frames. We see that your website has iframes. Usually this is not a problem for SEO if they are used properly. I don't really like iframes. I won't get into the technical complexity of iframes, but basically they allow you to show multiple sections of website alongside of each other. So my guess is you've probably got I don't know. This text that scrolls on top of that background image is probably an iframe. Without digging through the code, I don't know exactly what it is, but I would definitely look into checking that and make sure that the iframes are done well so that they don't cost you traffic or cause problems for visitors on other types of computers and other browsers and things like that. Lastly here, Google Analytics shows Google Analytics is not monitoring your website. We've already talked about that. I definitely think you should install Google Analytics. It would be good data. So Rick, I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up there. Like I say, I don't want to overwhelm you or keep you too long. I hope you found this to be informative and hope you found some information here that was useful to you. My ultimate goal is to become a resource for you, to earn your trust, and ultimately to become your go-to website guy. If you need some help making the changes that I've recommended here, if you've got other things that you'd like to do to your website, need some maintenance done, or want to talk about social media or search engine stuff or something like that, I'd absolutely love to talk to you about that and help you to implement those changes or help you out however you need help. So I'm going to package this video up to you up here in just a little bit and send it over to you. And once you have a chance to watch it, if you have questions or if you'd like to discuss it all, feel free to give me a call anytime. I'd also love to hear your feedback on this. These audits are fairly new to us. We haven't been doing this for very long, so I'd love to hear whether or not you found this to be useful and whether this is something we should continue or we should scrap. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll follow up with you in a few days just to make sure that you got my email and see if you had any questions and see if there's anything I can help you with. So thanks a lot for your time, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.